Ladies and gentlemen, please rise, please stand up as the High Commissioner and the Mayor have just arrived. You're requested to stand on your seats, please. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand up. Please rise in honor of Mayor of Mountain Forest and His Excellency the High Commissioner of Pakistan. His Excellency and the Mayor, you are requested to take the stage. Just ask please for your seat. And White Sheikh Kamal Raza on the stage as well, along with the High Commissioner and the Mayor, and Dr. Sohail Tulsai, President of WCOP UK. Please take your seats. Thank you so much indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Pakistan, the Pakistan Day ceremony organized by World Congress of Overseas Pakistanis in collaboration with lots of other organizations. We welcome you all. We welcome His Excellency the High Commissioner, Sayyid Ibn Abbas, who is delivering the keynote today. We welcome the Mayor and the youth mayors and Dr. Sohail Tulsai and all of you prestigious and notable guests. Ladies and gentlemen, we are here to commemorate the Pakistan Day ceremony, to in fact honor the 23rd of March 1940 of subcontinent, the Muslims of India got together and the historic Pakistan resolution was passed. This historic day, after 7 years, gave birth to Pakistan, our country and homeland. Today we are here to commemorate that great day and we are so much obliged for your presence over here. Today is 22nd of March and tomorrow, 23rd of March, is the ceremony. I'm also glad and it's a privilege to announce that Chairman World Congress of Overseas Pakistanis, Sajjad Karim MEP, would be receiving his honors tomorrow in Pakistan. He is receiving the highest civil award dedicated to those in fact who serve Pakistan or non-Pakistanis, though he's of Pakistani origin. So let's give him a big hand in appreciation of the services of Sajjad Karim MEP. The Chairman, World Congress of Overseas Pakistanis, sends his felicitations and wishes you all a very happy Pakistan Day tomorrow. Formally initiating the ceremony, I'll be requesting Sayyid Kamal Raza, who is co-chairman of World Congress of Overseas Pakistanis, to welcome all of you to today's event. May I invite Sayyid Kamal Raza, founder and co-chairman of World Congress of Overseas Pakistanis.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Your Excellency, High Commissioner for Pakistan, Mr. Mayor, colleagues, dosto, behno, bhaiyo, assalamu alaikum. Jaisa ki aap jante hain, aaj ki takreeb 23 March ke reference se munaqid ki gayi hai. Kyunki 23 March ki takreeb High Commission mein hoti hai, to isliye humne ek din iska inqaad ek din pehle rakha hai. کہ اس کے ساتھ متضاد نہ ہو یہ دن ہمارا آج کا دن بڑا اہم دن ہے جس مقصد کے لیے ہم یہاں اکٹھے ہوئے ہیں تاکہ ہم اپنے عہد کی تجدید کر سکیں پاکستان جو کہ عزیز عظیم مملکت ہے اس کو اپنی منزل کی طرف لے جا سکیں اور یہ جو مشکلات ہیں یہ عارضی مشکلات ہیں اور انشاءاللہ ہم سب مل کے کوشش کریں گے جس طرح سے پاکستان نے پہلے ترقی کی ہے اس سے بہتر طریقے سے ہم انشاءاللہ اس کو اس کی اصل منزل پہ لے کے جائیں گے انہی الفاظ کے ساتھ میں آپ سب کا مشکور ہوں کہ آپ نے اپنے قیمتی وقت میں سے ٹائم نکالا اور اس محفل کو رونق بخشی اور میں بالخصوص مشکور ہوں جناب ہائی کمشنر صاحب کا کہ انہوں نے بھی اپنی انتہائی مصروف پروگرام میں سے ٹائم نکالا और वाल्थमस्टो में आके इस महफिल को रौनक बख्शी। और इसके साथ ही मैं जनाब राजा लादित्ता साहब का, कौंसलर एहसान साहब का इंतहाई मशकूर हूँ कि उन्होंने हमारे साथ तावन किया और हमें ये हाल प्रोवाइड किया और हमारी रहनुमाई की वाल्थमस्टो में इस प्रोग्राम को इनेकाद करने में। इसके साथ साथ मैं मशकूर हूँ जनाब कौंसलर लियाकत चौधरी साहब का और उनके बेटे मेयर, फॉर्मर मेयर नदीम अली साहब का कि उन्होंने भी हमारे साथ इंतहाई तावन किया है। अल्लाह ताला आप सबका हामी और नासिर हो। मैं ज़्यादा टाइम नहीं लूँगा, बहुत शुक्रिया, अस्सलाम वालेकुम।
Thank you so much. When you look at these flag bearers, you could see the next generation of Pakistan, the proud daughters and sons of Pakistan. And we are so glad that you're here today. And you have been, in fact, really making a lot of effort and putting the flag up. And we are sure that you would keep the flag up like the way you would be doing it. So thank you so much. Please take your seats. 23rd of March is one of the most important days in the struggle of Pakistan. And that's why we are here today to commemorate the great event, which took place in Lahore on the 23rd of March 1940. I'll be inviting Dr. Sohail Chughtai, who is President of World Congress of Overseas Pakistanis, to shed light on the heart of the matter and share with you why 23rd of March is one of the most important days for all of us. In your applause, I would invite Dr. Sohail Chughtai, President of World Congress of Overseas Pakistan.
I want to greet all of you here. I think it's wonderful to see such a great turnout, and I'm thankful to the mayor, to the High Commissioner, to the chairman, WCOP, the youth mayors, and Arif for making this possible. We are celebrating a very important day which happened in 75 years ago, and that was 3 days convention of all Pakistan, all India Muslim League, which was presided by Mr. Jinnah. The convention happened on 22nd, 23rd and 24th March in Minto Park, Lahore. That Minto Park is Minare Pakistan now, as you know, and Mr. Jinnah proposed the idea of a separate state and proposed the idea of Muslims, 100 million of them living in common India that time, to be recognized as a nation. He conveyed that the political stance, the economic viability, the cultural and ethnic integrity can be best preserved if Muslims are given a state of their own. And there was a precursor of that. In 1937, the All India elections, the six provinces where Congress won, they refused the offer of having coaxial ministries. So Muslims felt at that time, if they want to preserve themselves as integrity, they must demand their own state. Especially there was an education system called Wardha. They felt that their cultural integrity was challenged in that education system. So Mr. Jinnah proposed the idea of all the Muslim majority states in northwest of India and eastern part of India to coalesce as one state. And that was the idea, that is what we are commemorating here today, the very idea which became constitution of the Muslim League in 1941, and in 1946, that was the straw point where the whole movement got galvanized, and that was where the whole thing got started and flared up. So we really want to celebrate that. It is the day we are commemorating that. Now, Mr. Jinnah loved integration, loved empowerment, and that is what WCOP is taking forward. We are here to promote empowerment. We are here to promote integration. When I say empowerment, you will see that many of the young members of the community, we are presenting them as leaders. They are presenting their cases today. They are coming up on stage. You will also see very senior members of the society who come and inspire others. And we are going to continue that. We are going to continue doing that. And when we talk of integration, here is an example. And I really congratulate the mayor that he has pulled up a great combination of integration, the 10 Muslim councillors led by the mayor. And I think this is an example of integration. And that's why we actually are here to celebrate the very, very purpose of WCOP. Now, integration is a word which is only complete if we learn, overseas Pakistanis, we learn to respect the law of this country, we learn the customs of this country, at the same time, we are able to practice our own. And to do that confidently, both sides, and preventing any friction between them, is the art. That's the art we have to learn. And once we do that, we are into integration. I hope you continue enjoying the afternoon. Thank you very much. Thank you.
خدا کرے میرے عرض پاک پر اترے خدا کرے میرے عرض پاک پر وہ صبح اترے جسے اندیشہ زوال نہ ہو آج ورلڈ کانگریس اوورسیز پاکستانیز کی طرف سے ورلڈ کانگریس آف اوورسیز پاکستانیز یو کے کی جانب سے دیر از بورڈ آف گورنرز بورڈ آف ایگزیکٹوز وہ لوگ جنہوں نے آج کی تقریب کا انعقاد کیا جو آج کی تقریب کے میزبان ہیں دوز ہوسٹس آف ٹوڈیز ایوننگ I'll be playing the anthem of World Congress of Overseas Pakistanis to introduce those people.
Ek hi malik, khalik sab ka, sab uski makhlooq. Ishq bhi, husn bhi, aashik bhi wo, aur wohi maashooq. Insaniyat saath na chode, jo bhi ho halaat. Pyaar hai manzil, hum hai rahi, haathon mein hai haath. Haathon mein.
چاند ستاروں سے ہے روشن اپنے دن اور رات پیار ہے منزل ہم ہے راہی ہاتھوں میں ہے ہاتھ چاند ستاروں سے ہے روشن اپنے دن اور رات پیار ہے منزل ہم ہے راہی ہاتھوں میں ہے ہاتھ سب ایک آسمان کے تارے ہیں ہم سب ایک دوسرے کے ساتھ
پاکستان ہے دور مگر ہم پھر بھی ہیں ایک ساتھ پاکستان ہے دور مگر ہم پھر بھی ہیں ایک ساتھ پاکستان ہے دور مگر ہم پھر بھی ہیں ایک ساتھ پاکستان ہے دور مگر ہم
Give a big hand to Tarana of World Congress of Overseas Pakistanis. And I'll be now inviting Tariq Suleiman, who is a member of Board of Executives of World Congress of Overseas Pakistanis and a professor at the prestigious School of Asian and African Studies at SWAS, London. So Tariq Suleiman will be taking it from there.
Thank you. ہم کو دیکھو ہماری صورت سے ہم کو دیکھو ہماری صورت سے منزلوں کا سراغ ملتا ہے پاکستان کے مستقبل کا وہ سراغ ہمیں اب بچوں کے چہروں پہ ملے گا اب پاکستان کی یوتھ ہے جس سے ہمیں یہ نشان ڈھونڈنا ہے تو ہم میں آج ایک ایسی شخصیت موجود ہیں جو جن کا پیشن یہی ہے کہ ان بچوں کو ڈیولپ کیا جائے اور ان بچوں کے لیے کام کیا جائے اب میں منیزہ بصیر کو سٹیج پہ آنے کی دعوت دیتا ہوں
ویری وارم ویلکم ٹو ایوری ون آئی تھنک دس واز ا سرپرائز فار می دیٹ آئی واز سپوز ٹو بی ہیئر اینڈ سے فیو ورڈز بٹ ایٹ دا سیم ٹائم آئی تھنک اٹس اے گریٹ آنر فار می that I have been a member of this WCOG and they have created a youth wing. I am a great believer of this, that we are very important, I being part of this generation, but more important are the youth. Our young people, if we give them right training, right education, see to it that their time goes in the sort of activities which are good for them, good for society and good for country. Then we can't lose it. I am very grateful to Dr. Suhail that he listened to what I said and he said, okay, go and create your youth. So I am very, very proud of that. And I have a young lady's name here. She is Rajya Bhatti. She is the one who's in charge of this. goodness. I'm very, I mean, I would like to see where she is, because she has a very, very important job. I hope whatever, yes, she's there, where is she? I'm a strong believer of this, that only those nations progress who give this importance to their younger people. Our younger people, they are very special, because in Pakistan, as we all know, they are a very large percentage. And also, what our younger people are doing, it is definitely taking us in some right direction. I won't take too much time, because I know there are lots of people and there are lots of good things which we have to hear. So thank you very much. Can I call the young leader again? Yeah. I didn't say enough about you,
no.
But I just wanted them to see you again and listen to you again. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Councillor Rabia Bhatti, who is the youngest female councillor in the UK, also happens to be member board of executive at World Congress of Overseas Pakistanis. Let's give a big hand to Rabia.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished dignitaries, Your Excellency, the Mayor, everybody here, assalamu alaikum, good afternoon and welcome. I am both honoured and privileged to be with you all here today to celebrate Pakistan Day, a day which brings to the forefront what it means to be a Pakistani national. As a young person, a policymaker, and a woman, I am incredibly proud of the accomplishments of our nation, our technological advancements, scientific and international progress. I am proud of our transition into a democratically elected nation and how it has been our country and the work of our people to produce the first female Prime Minister of Pakistan. Our nation has stood strong, not just strong in fact, but firm and resilient in the face of adversity, in the face of trials, tribulations, and challenges, both national and international. Having travelled to over 20 countries in the last 1.5 years alone, I am perhaps on one of the proudest stages I have been on here today in Walthamstow, with you all, to celebrate the birth of a nation that has given me a home, a heritage, an identity, and the presidential ward of Azadma. Thank you, first and foremost, to the World Congress of Overseas Pakistanis. Thank you to the Board of Directors and Governors who have worked tirelessly to provide us with a platform in order to engage, to learn, interact, and understand one another, to celebrate and look forward to the future, the prosperous future that Pakistan, I am sure and hope, will continue to have in generations to come. I hope you all here today will in fact support me in supporting the aims of this organisation, in indeed supporting our glorious nation, to empower women, children and all of its citizens, to become not just beacons of hope, success and progress, but indeed to leave their mark on the global landscape. Thank you very much for your time.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm going to invite another honourable guest who's within us, and she represents lots of NGOs in Pakistan. She works with them, and I would invite Mrs. Faiza Rizvi to come on stage and talk to us about her work in Pakistan.
Shukriya bahut bahut. Assalamu alaikum. Main Faiza Rizvi hu. Main Board of Governors World Congress of Overseas Pakistanis को बिलोंग करती हूँ. पाकिस्तान में इस वक्त मैं नंबर ऑफ NGOs के साथ काम कर रही हूँ जिसमें हम लोग smoking cessation यानी के सिगरेट पीने को बंद करने के लिए काम कर रहे हैं औरतों के लिए काम कर रहे हैं खास तौर पे disabled औरतें और बच्चों के लिए हमने एक dispensary बनाई है बाग में जो कि पाकिस्तान के जलजले के बाद थी वहाँ पे बहुत ज़्यादा कमी थी कि औरतों के इलाज के लिए खास तौर पे जब उन वो बच्चे छोटे होते हैं उसके इलाज के लिए बहुत कमी थी वो हम लोग स्पॉन्सर कर रहे हैं जिसमें काफ़ी तब्दीली आई है लोगों को अपनी सेहत के बारे में काफ़ी पता लगा है और ख़ास तौर पे औरतें और बच्चों की सेहत के लिए काम कर रहे हैं हम लोग वहाँ पे और अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह रब्बिल आलमीन के उससे हमें काफ़ी हमने ये देखा है कि हमें काफ़ी सपोर्ट मिली है पाकिस्तान से भी और यहाँ से भी अपने मेम्बर्स के साथ शुक्रिया बहुत बहुत तो अब ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ ओवरसीज ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ आवर रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वी वुड लाइक टू कन्वे आर वॉर्म पेट्रियाटिक फीलिंग्स फॉर ब्रिटिश पाकिस्तानी अटेंडिंग दिस सेरेमनी टूडे एंड फॉर दोज हु आर ऑल्सो वॉचिंग दिस ऑन लाइव इंटरनेट तो हम सब आप लोगों का यहाँ पे खुश आमदीद कहते हैं और आप सब लोगों के शुक्रगुजार हैं कि आपने हमें यहाँ ज्वाइन किया इस सेरेमनी में जहाँ पे हम सब मिलके पाकिस्तान की तरक्की को के लिए दुआ करें और पाकिस्तान में जो भी कुछ हो रहा है उसके लिए हम शामिल हो जाएं वी आर रिप्रेजेंटिंग आवर रिस्पेक्टिव ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वी एक्सप्रेस सॉलिडारिटी विद ओवरसीज पाकिस्तानी लिविंग इन ब्रिटेन ऑन दिस ओकेजन हम सब मिलके काम करना चाहते हैं हम सब यहाँ पे यूके में रहते हुए अपने मुल्क के साथियों के साथ मिलके यहाँ पे इंटीग्रेट होना चाहते हैं और हम उन सब के लिए यहाँ पे सपोर्ट प्रोवाइड कर सकते हैं और उन सब के साथ मिलजुल के काम करना चाहेंगे हम ये चाहते हैं कि हम सब मिलके यहाँ पे काम करें और एक दूसरे की मदद करें ताकि जितने भी ओवरसीज पाकिस्तानीज यहाँ पे रह रहे हैं वो सब मिलजुल के ब्रिटेन की मल्टीकल्चरल सोसाइटी में इंटीग्रेट करें और ब्रिटेन की मल्टीकल्चरल सोसाइटी के टूवर्ड्स हम कंट्रीब्यूट कर सकें और वहाँ पे यहाँ पे अपने मुल्क का नाम रोशन करें जब हम यहाँ पे रह रहे हैं हम वर्ल्ड कांग्रेस ओवरसीज पाकिस्तानी एसोसिएशन के बहुत शुक्रगुजार हैं कि उन्होंने हमें ये अपॉर्चुनिटी प्रोवाइड की सो वी कैन वर्क टुगेदर वी कैन रिले आवर मैसेज ऑन दिस ओकेजन वी वुड लाइक टू थैंक World Congress of East Pakistani for providing us with this opportunity to relay our message on this occasion of Pakistan Day. Thank you very much. Shukriya bahut bahut. I would like to now invite Chairman Dr. Shaukat Nawaz, Chairman UK Cultural Foundation, UK APFAS Association Chairman Bashan Rafiq, Nazia Hassan for Foundation Chairman Chairperson Muniza Bashir, and the Association of Pakistani Physician and Surgeon UK Dr. Sohail Chuksai, and President Rashid, President Cultural Society, Pakistan Cultural Society, President Rashid Akhtar. Thank you very much.
I think we just want to reflect upon our organizations. We represent many organizations, and you just heard Faizal is saying that we want to work together, and we are together with WCUP on this cause. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
मोम की सीढ़ी पे चढ़ के छू रहे थे आफ्ताब फूल से चेहरों को ये कोशिश बहुत महंगी पड़ी मैं राबिया भट्टी को एक बार फिर दावत देता हूँ कि वो आएँ और से कौंसल लियाकत अली साहब को इनवाइट करें
Thank you. It gives me absolutely great pleasure to invite here our next guest, a councillor who has worked fundamentally hard, not only for his own constituency and community, but indeed for Britain and Pakistan. Please join me in giving a round of applause to Councillor Liaquat.
Ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum to all of you. And it certainly gives me great pleasure to be here today. Aaj hum celebrate kar rahe hain Pakistan Day, Republic of Pakistan Day, jo resolution passed in 1940. So it's a great, great honor for me to be part of this celebration. I really want to thank the World Congress, obviously Pakistani, for bringing this day here early and all, but also bringing our chief guest, His Excellency the High Commissioner of Pakistan, here in Mortham Forest. It's a great, great honor for us on that basis. It's really important that hum Pakistan Day, jahan par bhi hame celebrate karna chahiye, aur yahan par aap dekhte hain Mortham Forest ki kitni badi community hai, Pakistani aur Kashmiri ki community yahan par, aur hamesha hamare dil Pakistan ke liye dhadakte rehte hain. Watan se dur rehkar bhi, watan se bakhabar hoon main, hoon jis mitti ka, us mitti se mujhe ishq-e-kamal hai. So, we are very, very proud of the diversity, Your Excellency, here in Mortham Forest, and certainly it's a great honor for us to have the flag raising here done today by yourself in Mortham Forest, and all those thanks goes to the Committee of World Congress of Overseas Pakistani and a few of the colleagues around it. Whatever happens, since 2007, and we have raised the flag of Pakistan here every year on the 23rd of March, whether it's a Republic Day of Pakistan, whether it's the 14th of August, Pakistan Independence Day, hum yahan par flag hamesha raise karte hain, aur karte bhi afternoon, we never clash with the High Commission, the flag raising in the morning. So it's a real great honor for us to have you here today to raise this flag again on this auspicious occasion. While I've got the mic, we are very, very proud of this borough here, and thanks to people like colleague Mr. Mayor, thanks to some of the colleague councillors, we here, Pakistani, the first female mayor in the United Kingdom was from this borough. Ms. Mayor Khan, please stand up. Be proud of being Pakistani. Yeah, we've also got friendship with me back in 2001, and we've got ties with Pakistan, so we do a lot of exchanges here, Your Excellency, so we're really, really proud. We are a diverse borough. We are 272,000 people, but one community. Irrespective of our color, creed, religion, sexuality, whatever, we stick together. Whatever happens, jab bhi koi aafat aati hai Pakistan mein, idhar hoye, we stick together on that basis. Last time jab earthquake hua Pakistan mein, yahan ka is baro mein, 75,000 pound inhone raise ki, 1 hour in one meeting yahan par is baro ki ye khushi hai. Yehi baro hai yahan par, yehi baro hai. This is the opportunity that I've got. I think you should know what's going on in this baro, and it's really important. Yehi baro hai yahan par jisne apne iqraidat, right of self-determination of Kashmiris, yehi baro hai, sabse pehle United Kingdom mein yahan par pass hui hai. Aur yehi baro hai jispe musalmanon ka kabristan, sabse pehle jo musalmanon ka separate kabristan is baro ne diya. Yehi baro hai pure London mein agar dekhen, 13 councillor hai Pakistani heritage on that basis. And we are really proud. Once again, I really want to welcome you here in this borough. May you keep on coming in this borough. I also want to thank our communities. Without the community, it does not happen. I want to once again thank the World Congress Overseas of Pakistan for bringing His Excellency the High Commissioner here. And I certainly hope you enjoyed whatever small visit here and keep on coming back here in Mortham Forest. میں اس شعر سے ختم کرتا ہوں ستی قوم جگائی دانا سے اقبال سونا پاکستان بنایا سونیا سوچن دینا
Thank you for that, Councillor Liaquat.
I'd now like to invite on another council member who has indeed contributed to wider society at large. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Councillor Essen Khan.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Sayyid Qamar Reza Shah Sahab, Your Excellency High Commissioner of Pakistan, Mr. Mayor, Councillor Wheeler, Youth Mayoress Krishma Mohammed, Dr. Sohail Chukdey, ladies and gentlemen, welcome and assalamu alaikum. I'd like to start by saying it's fantastic to see so many people here today, women, men, and also young children, here in Waltham Forest in the town hall celebrating Pakistan Day. As a British Pakistani, this is something that makes me very proud. The UK is known for its tolerance, London is known for its diversity, and Waltham Forest is known for its celebration of different cultures, of different nations. And we as a council go out our way, I'm sure, to recognise important days of nations throughout the year. I'm delighted the leader of the council, Councillor Chris Robbins, has also just joined us. Chris, do you want
to? I'll leave my chair. Thank you.
And my colleague, Councillor Liaquat Saab, has already touched upon the various different ways we are working with the wider community, but also celebrating Pakistani culture. But I think within the UK, we have many Pakistanis who are contributing to the economy, contributing to culture, and also socially. And I hope the High Commissioner, as he gets more involved in his work, will work closely with many of the overseas Pakistanis to help in improving the situation back in Pakistan. He will, of course, work as his role as the interface between the Pakistan government and citizens here in the UK. I'm sure we can build upon a lot of the work that has gone on previously. One of the ladies earlier spoke about smoking cessation, and I think in my role as the Cabinet Member for Health and Wellbeing, it's an important forum for me to just make everyone aware of a very important project which is taking place in Waltham Forest. It's the first research project involving the Pakistani community. So we all know that within the Pakistani community there are health issues such as diabetes, such as heart disease and blood pressure, which are far more prevalent than the rest of the population. So Queen Mary University is running a research project in Waltham Forest, Newham and a few surrounding boroughs to recruit volunteers from the Pakistani community to hopefully better understand why these health issues are most prevalent within these communities, and also to hopefully develop further medication to improve some of these issues in years to come. And I'm sure through this project we will see medical breakthroughs for many years to come, not just to support people in Waltham Forest or London, but I'm sure worldwide. And it's something that I would encourage all Pakistanis to get involved in. We have many people within this chamber who've already signed up as volunteers. So Councillor Liaquat Ali has also signed up, Dr. Shaukat Khan has signed up, Dr. Rashid Akhtar has also signed up, and I encourage you to all sign up for this project. You can find details on the web. I'd also just now like to welcome our local MP for Walthamstow, Stella Creasy, who has just arrived. Again, we are delighted that the Walthamstow MP and the leader of the council again are standing with the Pakistani community and celebrating events such as Pakistan Day with us all here on a Sunday, taking time out of their very busy schedules to join us for this very important event. I'd like to just finish by saying a couple of thank yous. I'd like to thank all my colleague councillors who have come here today. I would also like to thank Qamar Reza Shah Sahab for all of his work and his organising committee that have helped to organise this event. And also on behalf of my father, Raja Al-Dhidha Sahab, I would like to thank everyone else who has attended and made this event what it is. I hope you enjoy the rest of the event, and thank you again all for coming.
پاکستان کے مستقبل کی اگر ٹریجیکٹری دیکھنی ہو کہ وہ ترقی میں کب اور کہاں ہوگا तो उसको सिर्फ एक ही क्राइटेरिया से पे पूरा उतरना होगा और वो क्राइटेरिया तालीम का है। अगर हम 2003 के अदाद व शुमार देखें यूनाइटेड नेशन के किताबों के पब्लिश करने के, तो पाकिस्तान की 200 मिलियन की पॉपुलेशन में सिर्फ 2600 किताबें पब्लिश हुई, जबकि फिनलैंड जैसे 5 मिलियन लोगों के मुल्क में तकरीबन 27,000 किताबें पब्लिश हुई। तो इस सिलसिले में हमारे दरमियान एक स्कॉलर मौजूद हैं आज, जिन्होंने हाल ही में पीएचडी की है ऑक्सफोर्ड यूनिवर्सिटी से, और उनकी पीएचडी का थीसिस अब किताब की शक्ल में आ रहा है। मैं डॉक्टर सुंदस अली को दावत दूंगा कि वो स्टेज पे आए। While she is making her way to the podium, I'll introduce Dr. Sundas Ali. She is a graduate of Oxford University and she has recently completed her PhD from Oxford University. Dr. Sundas Ali, thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Naik. Assalamu alaikum to all of you and welcome to this great event. It's an honor to be here amongst all of you here. I've been really enjoying listening to all of you and the great work that's happening. I'm here today to talk about a report that I've just completed, and as well as my PhD in the topic of Muslims in Britain. This is from the University of Oxford, and the report that I'm going to talk about is called British Muslims in Numbers. This is the report which you can all access on the MCB website as well, which I'll tell you a bit more about now. But I would just like to start off by saying that the key messages in this report are many, and they cannot be summarized in this 3-4 minutes. But one phrase which I've just come up with is young, British, and entrepreneurial. These are the key findings in my mind which I would like you to all reflect on today. This report, which was launched in the House of Commons last month, I launched it there amongst a lot of MPs and many other people, and there's been, mashallah, really great coverage of it in the media. There was a need for a study like this. There hasn't been a study done looking at Muslims in Britain from a data perspective. We didn't have a comprehensive or a detailed study, and this is the first report of its kind. It provides us with objective analysis based on authoritative data. I took the data from the ONS, the Office for National Statistics. So this is authoritative data giving us hard facts. Now let's move on to the interesting part, which is what are the key findings of this report? As I said, there are many key findings, but I would like to reflect on a few. We found that Muslims form under 5% of the population in Britain. And this is contrary to popular belief, where some people believe that Muslims are taking over, you know, they are perhaps 20%, but this is not what the data tells us. The data tells us that Muslims form under 5% of the population. We find that Muslims are British. Almost half of them are born in Britain. They are proudly British, so the overwhelming majority of Muslims said that their national identity was British. That's 76%. I also found that we have an overwhelmingly young profile of Muslims, whose Muslim youth are prominent in England and Wales. 33% of Muslims were aged 15 years or under. Now this youth is a strategic asset in a time when the general population is aging. So what do we do with this Muslim youth? These are all questions which we must think and reflect on. I also found in terms of English language skills that actually only 6% of the population are struggling to speak English. This is positive news that Pakistanis and Bangladeshis are doing very well in terms of their English language fluency. So perhaps this is not what the media sometimes portrays is the problem to integration. English doesn't seem to be the greatest challenge. Now, in terms of education, which is of interest to most of us here, because I know, especially my own parents and many of you, place a great value in education. I found through this data analysis that there has been an increased level of education since 2001. So more and more Muslims are being educated, and almost half of them are female. In terms of family types, we found that most Muslim families are married with children. However, there are a small number of families where there are single parents or where Muslims are living alone. So there's some social isolation. In terms of housing, I found that Pakistanis are doing quite well. They 43% have their own properties, and they own this with a mortgage. So in terms of the housing sector, Pakistanis are prospering. And I see also that there is entrepreneurship in the Muslim community, and hence why my title is Young British and Entrepreneurs, because we see a great level of entrepreneurship and business activity. Now, a slightly challenging news is that deprivation is a real issue that we must think about. Almost half of the Muslims are living in the 10% most deprived areas in England and Wales. And this, other studies have shown, this can lead to your worst educational outcome or worst employment. So this is something that the government and also the local councils must really think about. In terms of health, I found that this is Muslims are struggling here. We find that elderly Muslims, in particular those females aged 65 plus, have bad or very bad health. So I would say deprivation and health are areas we must reflect on more and think, why is this happening? And this is where we need further research. I've been talking about this report on various platforms since it's come out, and it's really been overwhelming actually. The media has picked it up, and the launch went very well, and I'm very grateful to Mr. Sahil for giving me this platform today to share the findings with all of you, because I think it's essential that you all read this report and digest the information, because we need these numbers to understand where we are today, what's happening in Britain, what is our situation. And I'd like to share with you an exciting piece of news, which is that I will be following up these findings with TVapex, and we will be making maybe three or four programs based on the key findings of the report, where we will have experts and we will discuss some of these findings and give you more a more elaborate discussion. So this will be coming in April or May. So watch out for that. And I would really value your feedback and comments on that. And I would like you to watch it actually. In terms of the report, this is all the key findings. And thank you very much for listening today. Thank you very much to Mr. Zahir. And thank you very much to WCOP for giving me this platform. Thank you.
Councillor Nadeem Ali, I would like Councillor Nadeem Ali.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The Honourable, the Worshipful, the Mayor of Waltham Forest, His Excellency Sayyid Ibn Abbas Shasab, the Honourable Leader of the Council, Councillor Chris Robbins, our wonderful MP for Waltham South, Stella Creasy, and Dr. Sohail Chuktai Saab, my fellow councillors, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, I can see some small children here as well. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu to each and every single one of you. I know earlier, my uncle Amjad Mirza Saab, he stood up and he said that we are celebrating Pakistan Day, so some of the speeches should be said in Urdu. So if it's okay with you, ek sher mein, every time I try to do a Pakistani event, I use this sher, aur ye sher shasa mein aapke naam karta hu, ke ek shair hai, wo kehta hai ke wo mahboob mithan arbi hado lan, aur wo mahboob mithan arbi hado lan, او سرور دیاں ریساں کون کرے آپ میرا ساتھ دیں گے تو انشاءاللہ مزہ بھی آئے گا. We are here to celebrate Pakistan Day. Yeah, so let's liven up and let's enjoy the day as well. So آپ کہیں گے کہ کون کرے جی؟ So کہ وہ محبوب مٹھن عربی ہڈولن ਔਰ ਸਰਵਰਦੀਆਂ ਰੀਸਾਂ ਕੌਣ ਕਰੇ ਹੱਥ ਬਨ ਕੇ ਖੜੇ ਜਬਰੀਲ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਉਸ ਦਰ ਦੀਆਂ ਰੀਸਾਂ ਕੌਣ ਕਰੇ ਉੱਥੇ ਨੂਰ ਦੀਆਂ ਬਰਸਾਤਾਂ ਨੇ ਉਹ ਦੁੱਧ ਵਰ ਦੀਆਂ ਚਿੱਟੀਆਂ ਰਾਤਾਂ ਨੇ ਸਰਕਾਰ ਦੇ ਗੁੰਬਦ ਹਜ਼ਰਾ ਦੇ ਮਨਜ਼ਰ ਦੀਆਂ ਰੀਸਾਂ ਔਰ ਹੋਵੇ ਕੁੱਲ ਖੁਦਾਈ ਦਾ ਵਾਰਸ ਮੇਰੇ ਔਰ ਆਪਕੇ ਆਕਾ ਦੋ ਜਹਾਂ ਸਲਾਹ ਸਲਮ ਇਸ ਪੂਰੀ ਕਾਇਨਾਤ ਦੇ ਵਾਰਸ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਨਹੀਂ ਮਜ਼ਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਆ ਰਿਹਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੋਵੇ ਕੁੱਲ ਖੁਦਾਈ ਦਾ ਵਾਰਸ ਔਰ ਸੌਂਦਾ ਪਿਆ ਚਟਾਈ ਤੇ ਅਰੇ ਵਾਹ ਮਹਬੂਬ ਵਾਹ ਤੇਰੇ ਖੱਜੀਆਂ ਦੇ ਬਿਸਤਰ ਦੀਆਂ ਰੀਸਾਂ ਔਰ ਹੋਵਣ ਆਪਣੇ ਯਾ ਬੇਗਾਨੇ ਹੋਵਣ ਆਪਣੇ ਯਾ ਬੇਗਾਨੇ ਆਕਾ ਸਭ ਤੇਰੇ ਟੁਕਰਿਆਂ ਤੇ ਭਲਦੇ ਨੇ ਸਰਕਾਰ ਮਦੀਨੇ ਵਾਲੇ ਦੇ ਲੰਗਰ ਦੀਆਂ ਰੀਸਾਂ ਔਰ ਮੈਂ ਸ਼ਾਇਰੇ ਜ਼ਮਨ ਨਹੀਂ ਸ਼ਾਇਰੇ ਸ਼ਰੀਰ ਨਹੀਂ ਮੈਂ ਸ਼ਾਇਰੇ ਜ਼ਮਨ ਨਹੀਂ ਸ਼ਾਇਰੇ ਸ਼ਰੀਰ ਨਹੀਂ ਯਜ਼ੀਦੀਅਤ ਕੀ ਮੇਰੇ ਹੱਥ ਪੇ ਲਕੀਰ ਨਹੀਂ ਮੈਂ ਜਬ ਤੱਕ ਅਲੀ 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 ਨਾ ਕਹੂੰ ਯੇ ਹੋ ਸਕਤਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਮੈਂ ਗੁਲਾਮ ਫਾਤਹ ਹੈਬਰ ਹੂੰ ਬੇਜ਼ਮੀਰ ਨਹੀਂ I know I've taken up a lot of time, but I thought I need to engage with the crowd, you see, because everybody was sitting very all like, you know, idhar koi pata nahi kya ho raha hai. Let's liven up the atmosphere here. Today we are celebrating Pakistan Day here in Waltham Forest, and I'm very, very proud to be here and to be celebrated and be part of this celebration of Pakistan Day, which obviously the host and we are very grateful to the Mayor of London Borough Waltham Forest for facilitating, and obviously Raja Asan Khan Sahab and obviously the World Congress of Overseas Pakistanis that are doing this event, and it is an absolute honour and a privilege for me to be here. So please, I know I've already been tapped on the shoulder once, so I'm not going to take up too much of your time, but have a wonderful, wonderful day. I would just like to inform you though that in 2007 we here in the First Council, I'm very, very proud to say that we were the first people to put up the Pakistan flag on the 23rd of March, and that was done and I'm very proud to be his son by my noble father, Councillor Liaquat Ali MBE JP Sahab. And so thank you very much, and that tradition has been carried on, and so tomorrow at 3 o'clock we will be doing it again. So if any of you all have the time, please do come along, because tomorrow we will officially mark and put up the Pakistan flag here as we've been doing for the last 7-8 years since 2007. But thank you very much for allowing me to say a few words. Yeah, and I would like to end on this share, Shah Sahab. And again, this share is for you. And this share is a very special share because it is from my Murshid-e Kareem, my Murshid-e Azeem, Hazur Mufakkir-e Islam, Dr. Peer Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani Shah Sahab. He says, Ke ilme Ali ki doom hai kul kainat mein. Ilme Ali ki doom hai. کل کائنات میں فضل علی کا رنگ ہے ہر بات بات میں بغض علی سے باز آ اے وقت کے یزید حب علی کو دخل ہے تیری نجات میں ما علی ما علی
My apologies, I'll speak in the Urdu and then I'll translate as well. ہم پردیس پہ جب پاکستان کے بارے میں کچھ سنتے ہیں یا پاکستان کے بارے میں کچھ پڑھتے ہیں تو جو درد کی کیفیت ہے اسے بیان کرنا مشکل ہے. میں پروین شاکر کے اس شعر سے اسے بیان کرنے کی کوشش کروں گا. درد اتنا کہ جگر آنکھ سے کٹ کٹ کے بہے, درد اتنا کہ جگر آنکھ سے کٹ کٹ کے بہے, ایک وعدہ ہے کہ رونے نہیں دیتا مجھ کو. لیکن ان مایوس کن حالات میں بھی جب ہم پاکستان کے انٹرپرینیورز کو دیکھتے ہیں, ان کی innovative abilities ko dekhte hain aur jab hum ye dekhte hain ki wo har tarah ki mushkilat ke bawajood apne aap ko apni jagah banane mein kamyab hote hain to hame pakistan ke roshan mustaqbil ki kuch umeed ki kiran nazar aati hai main ek aisi hi umeed ki kiran amti ahmed ko stage pe madhu karta hu amti ahmed
Assalamu alaikum everyone. Zuban hum koi bhi bole, English ya Urdu, lekin hum mohabbat sabse kare. I think ye sabse strong Pakistan ka message hai. Is waqt Pakistan ke halaat ke mutabik. I'm here to invite Dr. Shahid Siddiq, a consultant neurosurgeon. He's working at University Hospital Coventry. He's a student of history, South Asian history, and currently making a documentary on history of Pakistan. Thank you very much for having me here. Thank you.
I'm going to present to you the instrumental version of a very sweet Pakistani patriotic song. Bartaniya mein jab main Urdu sunta hoon to ek sher mere zehen mein aata hai. Urdu hai jiska naam हम ही जानते हैं दाग उर्दू है जिसका नाम हम ही जानते हैं दाग सारे जहां में धूम हमारी जुबान की है
Now we are drawing close to the end of the ceremony. We have only three speakers left. And our next speaker is the local MP, Sala Qureshi, who has been a great friend of Pakistan. We welcome her to this event. We'd like her to express her views at this auspicious ceremony. Sala.
Assalamu alaikum. Can you hear me? I look out today and I see many friends and neighbours as well as our distinguished guests. And as they will know me, we have been neighbours for almost 18 years here in Walthamstow. They know I cannot offer the beautiful fluency of tone of Councillor Nadeem Ali. I'm afraid I cannot also offer to play music in such a beautiful way either, but I can start my contribution today by making a firm commitment to you that I will not seek to sing to you. Any of you who have heard my voice will also know it is similarly challenged. But what I do want to do is put on record my grateful thanks for all the learning and insight that you have given me, especially in these last 5 years when I have been lucky enough to serve you as your Member of Parliament in Westminster. And I was very, very struck. I want to pay congratulations to Dr. Sundar Ali. Having completed a PhD myself, I know how much of a challenge it is to take all your ideas and turn them into prose. So congratulations. But you put on record much more beautifully than I ever could why politics matters. Why, for me, I have been driven to seek to serve my local community. Because you talked about the potential that exists within our Muslim community here in Britain. And it has been an honour to me to be able to work with, and I speak to the mums and dads in this audience today, the young people in our community, to see how much potential that they have and to see that what you are saying is completely true. And I am driven in politics by the fundamental fear that if we do not support each other, we will miss out on that potential. So when you have wonderful facts and figures that will confirm those arguments for us, I am confident that we can make that case about just how important it is to support our young people. You said our young people are an asset and we must see every young person in our community in that way, but especially those young people from our Muslim communities who are not getting the support they need to achieve what they are capable of doing. And if I may be so bold, there are a number of people in this audience today who prove that case more than I ever can. Those young people from our local community who have come to serve their local community on our local council. So not just Councillor Nadeem Ali, but also Councillor Khan and his work on diabetes. It's phenomenal. This country faces many challenges. You will have heard people talking about them. If I told you that as a country we are spending 10% of our entire National Health Service budget on our failure to treat diabetes, so not diabetes itself, but our failure to treat it, then you will know one of the burning issues for us as a society in the next 10 years is to resolve that. So the leadership that Asan is showing on this issue will not just make lives better in this community, but across the whole of our country, and he should be congratulated for that. So too, I just want to put on record my thanks for being able to work with people like Johar and Shabana and Saima as well. Young people who have shown, I can call you young because I think I'm just a little bit older than you, so, who have shown the leadership in our community, for our Muslim community and for Walthamstow, and we are better for it as a society for the work that they have done. Because it can be very difficult at this point in time to have hope, to have faith that things can be better, that things can be different. Let me tell you, when I walk into Westminster every day, we see many different challenges, both here in the UK and internationally. And there are some who wish to say that those challenges internationally, or even those challenges here in our community, are for other people to deal with. Let me tell you, it has been an honour to stand alongside my Muslim brothers and sisters here in Walthamstow in tackling those issues in our local community, and yes, raising those concerns at a national level too. Whether it is what happens in Kashmir, in Gaza, in Syria or in Burma, we have stood together as a community and said, we are all human beings. We all deserve freedom. We all deserve security. We deserve the right to look after our families in safety and prosperity. And it has been an honour to learn insight from you in how to make that case when sometimes it feels so difficult to have hope. In the last couple of months, I've had the honour to work with some Muslim scholars in learning about Islam and learning about some of the lessons and insights that it offers. So if I may, and I hope that you will forgive me in terms of my quotation, I would just like to share with you something that has struck me very strongly, which is a scholar who told me that the Quran teaches you that when you're out of ideas, that is where faith comes in. I draw my faith from the community in Walthamstow. I draw my faith from the way in which you have represented our Muslim community here and the way in which you have supported action across the world. And I hope, God willing, that I may be able to work with you in the future too. Thank you so much for inviting me today and letting me share in this wonderful celebration. Thank you.
Thank you, Stella. And I wish you all the best for May onwards. Now, this is the time, in fact, for the keynote address. We are honored today to have the High Commissioner of Pakistan, His Excellency Sayyid Ibn Abbas, over here. As all of us understand, tomorrow is 23rd of March, and Pakistan High Commission is hosting the National Day. Pakistan High Commission is hosting its official ceremony on the 23rd of March. And the High Commissioner has been terribly busy and engaged, but we are privileged to have him here today. We have two more speakers afterwards, so this is the keynote, in fact. So We will request His Excellency, the High Commissioner of Pakistan, Sayyid Ibn Abbas, to come over and deliver his keynote address at this ceremony.
Assalamu alaikum. I'll be speaking for a couple of minutes in English, then I'll switch on to Urdu with your permission. MP Stella Cressy, Honorable Mayor Wheeler, Leader of the Council, Chris Robin, councillors, and I have been introduced to some. I would like to name them because you know that I was introduced to them. Councillor Liaquat Ali Saab, Councillor Nadeem Ali Saab, Councillor Ehsan Saab, Raja Aladitya Saab, and all the other honourable councillors. Assalamu alaikum. It's indeed an honour and pleasure to be at the wonderful borough of Waltham Forest, as Pakistan and UK enjoy very cordial and warm relations. So I think this borough is the manifestation of those relations, because I am told this is a place which is very multicultural and which is a reflection of the welcoming nature of this great country. Let me begin by felicitating all of you on the Pakistan Day today. Ladies and gentlemen, 75 years ago, the Pakistan Muslim League had a vision, and that was to have a separate homeland for the Muslims of the subcontinent. And exactly 7 years later, on 14th of August 1947, a new country, a new nation, a new state emerged on the globe, and that was called Islamic Republic of Pakistan. So today we are celebrating the 75 years of that resolution, which was passed on 23rd of March at Lahore. Lahore is the capital of Punjab, which is the most populous state of Pakistan and the most culturally rich city of Pakistan. With this, I would be thanking the Honorable Mayor for letting us come to this great town hall, where I really feel honored being being present, and for the opportunity where we were able to raise the flag of Pakistan together. So I am grateful to him, as well as all the councillors who have made it possible, and I am looking forward to the other occasions to come and interact with the councillors and the cabinet of this great Waltham Forest borough, which, as I said, really reflects the multiculturalism of this great country. So, Honorable Mayor and MP, with your permission, can I switch on to Urdu, our national language? Mr. Saab, I think, has left, but nonetheless, I will continue. Acha, here. Yeah. Okay. So, Khawateen Hazrat, mere liye bahut hi baise izaz hai ye aaj ke main aapke darmiyan aaya hoon aur aise ahem mauke pe, jabki aaj isko Pakistan ke yom e Pakistan ke naam se is din ko manate hain. To alhamdulillah, aaj humne jhanda bhi lehraya hai bahar, jis tarah bhi inhone bataya ki kal bhi hamare safarkhane mein bhi taqreeb hogi subah 10 baje inshaallah sharp. आपको मैं दावत देता हूं, आप तशरीफ लाइए और अपनी खुशियां हमारे साथ बांटिए. ख्वातीन हजरात, पाकिस्तान जो आपके ख्वाबों की ताबीर है, इसमें कोई शक नहीं कि आप सब पाकिस्तान के सफीर हैं. हम तो एक आपकी खिदमत के लिए आते हैं, लेकिन असल में पाकिस्तान के सफीर आप हैं, और आप जो कुछ कर रहे हैं, हम उसके लिए हम आपके शुक्रगुजार हैं. हम आपके साथ इंशाल्लाह कदम से कदम मिलाकर आगे बढ़ना चाहते हैं. जस्ट वेरी ब्रीफली मुझे आपसे सिर्फ बताना है कि हम आपसे क्या तवक्को करते हैं. हम आपसे तवक्को करते हैं कि आप अपने आप को लुक आफ्टर करिए. यू प्लीज लुक आफ्टर योरसेल्फ. और हम आपके लिए दुआ करते हैं और आप हमारे लिए दुआ कीजिए, क्योंकि जो कुछ आप कर रहे हैं, आप पाकिस्तान की बेहतरीन खिदमत कर रहे हैं. मगर इसके अलावा ज्यादा जो मैं देखता हूं, कुछ हमारे दोस्त, कुछ अहबाब जो ज्यादा मीडिया से इन्फ्लुएंस होते हैं, तो वो हर वक्त परेशान रहते हैं. मैं आपके सामने अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह बड़े इत्मीनान से कह रहा हूं कि पाकिस्तान बहुत तेजी से आगे बढ़ रहा है। अगर 47 से लेकर आज तक आप देखें तो पाकिस्तान ने बहुत बड़ा सफर को कवर किया है। प्रॉब्लम्स हैं, अभी यहां से भी कहा गया, किसी साहब ने कहा कि बावजूद इन प्रॉब्लम्स के हम बढ़ रहे हैं। यस, प्रॉब्लम्स हैं, प्रॉब्लम्स हर जगह है। क्या जब आप यहां आए थे, अभी कांसलर लियाकत अली साहब ने कहा कि हमने यहां पे कब्रिस्तान बना लिया है, क्या ये कब्रिस्तान पहले था जब ये आप लोग आए थे? नहीं था। आपने मिलजुल के काविश की, आपने हिम्मत की, आज आपका कब्रिस्तान है। इसी तरह से मैं आपसे तवक्को करूंगा, आपसे रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा और आपसे एक मुअत्तबाना गुजारिश करूंगा कि आपके इख्तलाफात जो भी हों या हो सकते हैं, आफ्टरऑल हम इंसान हैं, हमारे इख्तलाफात हर किस्म के हो सकते हैं, मगर कौमी मामलात पे मैं आपसे दरख्वास्त करूंगा कि बराए खुदा आप कौमी मामलात पे यूनाइटेड रहिए, यूनिटी दिखाइए। उसी यूनिटी की वजह से आज अगर आपने ये मुख्तलिफ काउंसलर साहबान यहां तशरीफ रखते हैं, उनके कुछ भी ख्याल हो सकते हैं, लेकिन जब कौमी मामलात पे मुत्तहिद हुए, यूनाइट हुए, तो आज इधर आपका कौमी परचम भी लहराया जाता है, इधर आपके कौमी दिन भी मनाए जाते हैं। तो ये है यूनिटी और इत्तेहाद की बरकत। मैं आपसे सिर्फ यही चाहता हूं कि आप जिस तरह से यूनाइटेड होकर कर रहे हैं, अभी बताया गया कि कश्मीर जो अर्थक्वेक आया था 75,000 इधर इकट्ठे हुए, मैं उसके लिए अभी मौलाना साहब ने फरमाया कि कश्मीर में मस्जिद के लिए 1,25,000 पाऊं, मैं आपको सलाम करता हूं, मैं आपको सल्यूट करता हूं कि यस, आप बहुत ही फराख दिल कम्युनिटी हैं, आप हमेशा पाकिस्तान के लिए आपके दिल धड़कते हैं, जब भी पाकिस्तान की जरूरत होती है आपने कभी भी ना अपने वॉलेट्स ना अपने दिल को तंग किया है। तो मैं आपका उसके लिए शुक्रगुजार भी हूं, मैं आपको मुबारकबाद भी देना चाहता हूं। लेकिन साथ ही साथ पाकिस्तान इंशाल्लाह कदम ब कदम आगे बढ़ रहा है, तरक्की की राहें और मंजिलें तय कर रहा है। अभी बताया गया कि जी बड़े मसाइल हैं, यस मसाइल हैं, मगर मैं आपसे ये फिर क्योंकि अक्सर मुझे यकीन है कि कुछ लोग कहते हैं, मैं जगह कई जगहों पर जाता हूं, लोग मुझे तवक्को करते हैं मैं भी आपको वही कहानी सुनाऊं या वही बातें सुनाऊं जो आप सुनना चाहते हैं कि जी बस तबाही हो गई है, जी खत्म हो गया जी हर चीज में। आई कांट से दैट, आई हैव टू बी वेरी ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड आई हैव टू बी वेरी 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 पॉजिटिव, बिकॉज द रीजन इज कि मैं आपके साथ जो फैक्ट्स आपके सामने पेश करूंगा आपका अपना फैसला है। अभी 17 मार्च की ब्लूमबर्ग की एक रिपोर्ट आई है पाकिस्तान की इकॉनमी में, अगर आपको टाइम मिले जरूर देख लीजिएगा, उसमें भी यही बात की गई है कि बावजूद मसाइल के पाकिस्तान इस वक्त आगे बढ़ रहा है, पाकिस्तान का ग्रोथ रेट बताया गया है, पाकिस्तान के जो इंडिकेटर्स बताए गए। तो मैं आपसे ये बताना चाह रहा हूं कि इस वक्त इंशाल्लाह हमारे जो फंडामेंटल्स हैं मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स के सही हैं, पाकिस्तान तरक्की की तरफ जा रहा है। बावजूद के मैं अपने मीडिया को खराज तहसीन पेश करता हूं, जिस तरह से हमें वो इन्फॉर्म रखते हैं, जिस तरह से हमें वो हमारी रहनुमाई करते हैं, साथ कुछ जो चीज मीडिया वहां के लिए पाकिस्तान के पैकेज तैयार कर रहा होता है, जब आप यहां देखते हैं यकीनन आपको मेरी तरह आपको भी इससे परेशानी होती है, लेकिन वो पाकिस्तान एक बहुत बड़ा मुल्क है, 20 करोड़ आवाम का मुल्क है, उसमें कई जगहों पे ऐसे मामला हो सकते हैं जिनसे आपको और हमें परेशानी है, और हुए हैं वाला वाकयात हुए हैं, हादसात हुए हैं जिन पे हमें बड़ी परेशानी हुई, लेकिन इसका मतलब नहीं कि खुदा ना खास्ता सब कुछ बह गया। आप इत्माद रखिए, अपने ऊपर इत्माद रखिए, अपनी ममलकत पे इत्माद रखिए और आगे बढ़िए। जिस तरह आप हमें हमारी सपोर्ट करते हैं, हम भी आपकी सपोर्ट करते हैं, कदम से कदम मिला के चलेंगे। आपकी मुसल्ला फौज इस वक्त एक बहुत बेहतरीन और कामयाब मिशन के ऊपर है, आप उनके लिए सपोर्ट भी कीजिएगा, ख्वाहिशात का उनके लिए नेक तमन्नाएं भी रखिए। इंशाल्लाह मैं आपको यकीन से कहता हूं कि जो आपके खदशात हैं, जो आपकी परेशानियां हैं, बहुत जल्द मैं समझता हूं, आई होप आई एम राइट इंशाल्लाह, कि अगले चंद माह में उनके आप नतीजे देखेंगे। तो ये तो मैंने ब्रीफली आपको बताना चाहा कि प्लीज ये जो जो है आपकी डिस्पोंडेंसी है या ये जो आपकी ये जो है एक परेशानी है इसको थोड़ा सा रैशनलाइज करने की जरूरत है मैं ये मुझे यकीन है कि आपके दिल पाकिस्तान के लिए धड़कते हैं आप पाकिस्तान के लिए जज्बात रखते हैं इसलिए आप परेशान भी रहते हैं लेकिन आप बहुत सी जो पॉजिटिव चीजें हो रही हैं उनको भी जरूर देखा कीजिएगा और फिर उसके बाद एनालाइज कीजिए जब आप यहां आए आपके क्या इस वक्त हालात थे और आज 40 या दो जनरेशन या तीन जनरेशन के बाद वेयर डू यू स्टैंड तो ये आपको एनालाइज करने की जरूरत है कि इंसान याद रखे कि कतरा कतरा दरिया बनता है तो ये तो थी जी मैंने मुख्तसरन आपसे पाकिस्तान के बारे में करनी थी कि हम शुक्रगुजार हैं आपका आपकी सपोर्ट के लिए और जब भी हमें जरूरत हुई अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह आपने हमें कभी मायूस ना किया मैं आपका शुक्रगुजार हूं वेरी ब्रीफली जो हम एज ए सफारतखाना अब यहां आपके लिए करना चाह रहे हैं मैं गुजारिश आप पेश करना चाहूंगा देखिए जी मैंने कहा शायद कुछ लोगों को ये समझ नहीं आई इस वक्त मैं फिर आपसे दोहराना चाहता हूं कि मैं जब तक हूं यहां बहसीत हाई कमिश्नर मेरा मकसद एक है फकत एक आप लोगों की खिदमत उसमें कभी हम कोताहियां हमसे होती रहेंगी लेकिन आप भी कुछ थोड़ा दरगुजर कीजिए हमसे तावन कीजिए बेहतरी आएगी इंशाल्लाह अगर नहीं आएगी तो मेरा ख्याल में हमारा यहां पे रहने का मकसद नहीं है मैं तीन चार चीजें गुजारिशात आपके सामने पेश करता हूं मुझे मालूम है जी कि नादरा इस बहुत बड़ा इश्यू है नादरा मैं आपसे गुजारिश करना चाह रहा हूं कि हम 8000 एप्लीकेशन हर महीने प्रोसेस कर रहे हैं 8000 सफारतखाने में लंदन में और बाकी तीन जो हमारी कॉन्सुलेट्स हैं इसके लिए हमें रिसोर्सेज की भी जरूरत है इसके लिए हम एडिशनल रिसोर्सेज भी ले रहे हैं और कुछ नहीं है अब मसला यह है जी कि एक को 12 से 14 मिलियन लोगों के कार्ड्स बनाने जो कि अभी एक्सपायर हो चुके हैं ओवरनाइट मुश्किल है नामुमकिन है मगर हम अपने पूरे जितने रिसोर्सेज हैं उनको ला रहे हैं अपने जेर इस्तेमाल अभी वजीर दाखिला पिछले दिनों आए हुए थे उनसे हमने गुजारिश की उन्होंने कुछ एडिशनल स्टाफ भेजा है उस स्टाफ आने के बाद इंशाल्लाह आप बेहतरी देखेंगे लेकिन सब्र से काम लीजिएगा क्योंकि मैं जब अपने अफसरों को कहता हूं कि जनाब ये क्यों हम नहीं इनके मसाइल को हल कर सकते तो बताया जाता है कि सर थोड़ा सा ऑल्दो आई डोंट एग्री मैं उनसे इस चीज से इतफाक नहीं करता मगर मैं आपसे शेयर कर रहा हूं जो मुझे जवाब दिया जाता है मैंने कहा सर एनएचएस में तो 3 महीने इंतजार करते हैं यहां पर एक घंटा भी इंतजार नहीं कर सकते बट आई डोंट बाय दैट आर्ग्यूमेंट आई टेल देम नो we have to give them a better service that's what they deserve because we have to give them the what they deserve and they deserve better services I think many a times we have failed but we will improve ourselves ek to ye hai ji dusri guzarish aapki jo main samajhta hu is waqt bahut bada masla tha jerry's ka jab main aaya 5 maah pehle maine vaada kiya tha ki hum isko isme behtri lane ki koshish karenge ये 5 साल का जी एक मुहैदा हुआ है अब 2 साल हुए 3 साल अभी इसमें मजीद हैं और हमारे साथ एक कानूनी डॉक्यूमेंट साइन हुआ है उस कानूनी डॉक्यूमेंट के तहत हम पाबंद हैं बहरहाल दरिया को कूजे में बंद करते हुए हमने बड़ी कोशिश की अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह मैं आपसे ये शेयर कर सकता हूं कि आज वो जो 36 पाउंड पर एप्लीकेशन की फीस थी हमने बसर मुश्किल उसको 30 पाउंड पे करवा लिया ये एक हमारी मैं समझता हूं हमारी मतलब जेन्युइन और सिंसियर कोशिशों और काविशों का नतीजा इसी तरह से जी मैं मुझे एहसास है कि आप तमाम लोग वीक डेज पे कॉन्सुलेट्स में या सफारतखाने में तशरीफ नहीं ला सकते हमने अपने ताई एक और आपके लिए खिदमत शुरू की है कि हम हर महीने के दूसरे हफ्ते को एवरी मंथ सेकेंड सैटरडे ऑफ एवरी मंथ हम सफारतखाने को भी खोलते हैं और तमाम कॉन्सुलेट्स को भी खोलते हैं कि आप लोग जो वीक डेज पे सफारतखाने में अपने मामलात के लिए तशरीफ नहीं ला सकते उन दिनों में आके आप अपने मामलात को वहां से एड्रेस कराइए तीसरा मुझे यकीन है और मुझे मुकम्मल इस चीज का इल्म है जी के टेलीफोन पे हमारे इश्यूज हैं जहां भी और कॉन्सुलेट्स में उसके लिए हमने एक हल ये ढूंढा है दैट्स नो रीजन दैट आई से कि जी टेलीफोन शुड नॉट बी आंसर्ड और अटेंडेड हम उसके ऊपर भी काम कर रहे हैं मैं सफारतखाने में एक नया एक्सचेंज लगवा रहा हूं ताकि ये जो बहुत पुरानी एक लोगों की एक कंप्लेंट है उसको मैं एड्रेस करूं बट साथ ही साथ हमने 16 मार्च चंद दिन में पहले से अब ऑनलाइन अपॉइंटमेंट सिस्टम भी शुरू कर दिया, ताकि कोई भी आप में से खातून या साहब ऑनलाइन स्मार्टफोन से, अपने पीसी से, अपने लैपटॉप से हमारा कोई भी सर्विस के लिए आप अपनी अपॉइंटमेंट ले सकते हैं, कैंसिल कर सकते हैं, चेंज कर सकते हैं, आगे कर सकते हैं। तो ये इसी तरह से हमने एक वेबसाइट को नया डेवलप किया है। ये तमाम हम कोशिशें करें आपकी खिदमत के लिए, लेकिन मैं ये कह रहा हूं कि अभी भी हम उस जगह नहीं पहुंचे जहां हमें होना चाहिए, बिकॉज यू डिजर्व मच बेटर देन दैट। क्योंकि जब हमें जरूरत होती है आपने कभी भी, अब कभी भी पीछे नहीं हटे, इसीलिए हम भी पूरी कोशिश करेंगे कि आपको बेहतर से बेहतर सर्विसेज दें। मैं ज्यादा लंबा नहीं करना चाहता, बिकॉज आई नो पीपल, द ऑनरेबल मेयर हैज टू ऑल्सो स्पीक आफ्टर मी एंड आई थिंक दे हैव सेवरल स्पीचेस, बट आई डोंट वांट टू कंटिन्यू। बट लास्ट थिंग बिफोर आई यू नो आई विल बेग योर परमिशन, कि मैं जब से आया यहां पर कहा गया कि जी सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम है कि जी कॉन्सुलेट इन बर्मिंघम, मैं पिछले जुमे को 13 मार्च को मैं गया और वाकई मेरा सर शर्म से झुक गया कि क्या इस मुल्क में, क्या ऐसे ममालिक में, क्या ऐसी जगहों पे हम ऐसी खदमात और ऐसी बिल्डिंग्स में हम लोगों को आपको जहमत देते हैं। तो अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह जब मैं 13 मार्च को गया उसके बाद हमने फैसला किया कि अब वो सफारत, वो जो कॉन्सुलेट है उसकी हमने नई बिल्डिंग का एहतमाम कर लिया, इंतजाम कर लिया है, और इंशाल्लाह इंशाल्लाह विद इन फ्यू वीक्स जब हम उसको इस काबिल कर लेते हैं, इट्स अ काउंसिल बिल्डिंग, किसी की प्राइवेट बिल्डिंग नहीं है, इट्स अ 3 फ्लोर। पहले हम ऑपरेट कर रहे थे कुछ 2000 स्क्वायर फीट से, अब हम 7000 स्क्वायर फीट बिल्डिंग लिए, जिसमें लोगों को एहतराम से, इज्जत से, विच यू डिजर्व, हम आपको वेलकम करेंगे, आपको सर्विसेज देंगे। तो ये चंद चीजें मैं आपको गोशगुजार करना चाहता था, फिर मैं एक दफा फिर आप सबसे शुक्रिया अदा करना चाहता हूं आपकी पेशेंट हेयरिंग का, आपका मुझे यहां पे दावत देने का, वेलकम करने का। इंशाल्लाह ये रास्ते रहेंगे। आई एम ग्रेटफुल टू ऑल ऑफ यू एंड वंस अगेन आई एम ग्रेटफुल टू द ऑनरेबल मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट हू कुड मेक इट कन्वीनियंट टू कम एंड जॉइन अस दिस आफ्टरनून, ऑल्सो टू द ऑनरेबल मेयर एंड द लीड काउंसिल एंड अदर काउंसिलर्स हू हैव टेकन वेरी यू नो लार्ज प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ द डे फ्रॉम आफ्टर द टाइम टू बी विद अस to celebrate this very auspicious occasion. And I am grateful to all the distinguished guests who have come this afternoon. God bless you. Pakistan, Paindaba.
Thanks very much, Your Excellency. Ye the Pakistan ke High Commissioner sahab. Now I would like to take it's my honor to ask leader of the council, Councillor Chris Robbins, to come on the podium. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum to you all. Good afternoon. Good to see what a wonderful attendance today. Your Excellency, Mr. Mayor, Stella, fellow councillors and friends, welcome. Can I say, Your Excellency, we have many events in this room for the Pakistan community and the Muslim community, and I've never seen it so full for so many important people. That's with respect to yourself for coming today. Thank you very much. The Commissioner, of course, has only been in post for 5 months, so I think that we are very honoured that you're with us today. And I think the message that I want to give to you, yes, we do have a very diverse community, but the Pakistan community in Waltham Forest is huge. It's one of the biggest in London and one of the most important communities to Waltham Forest. Pakistani heritage people teach our children in schools, they run our businesses, they are involved in all aspects of life within Waltham Forest, and of course many of them are councillors within Waltham Forest, and you heard two of them today. I wasn't here earlier, in case anybody else spoke, but Arsan and also Nadeem. And I have to say, you know, I've got to say about Nadeem, although I didn't understand Nadeem again half of what you said, I enjoyed every word of it. I have to say, when we have full council in here, and Nadeem sits just over there, and it all goes quiet when he stands up. I think it does. But thank you very much for being here. As I said, the Pakistan community is extremely important to us, and it's a great honour for you to be here. I have to say to you that you won't just find that we are friends here to yourself and the job that you do, but we will be good friends to you. Your job will be very, very difficult and very important, and I can assure you that if ever you need time to rest, take some time out, come to us, and we will find you a place where you can gather your thoughts. The holy month of Ramadan is not very far away. I know your diary is very busy, but if I can make an offer on behalf of all of our community to invite you back during that period of time, it will be a further great honour for us to I know we're moving towards the close, and I have to say this is one of the first times we've actually kept the time at one of our meetings, which is also wonderful. But thank you all very much for coming today to show our respects to the Commissioner and to the work that he does, but also recognising, Commissioner, that many people in this room have big families and important families back home, and it's important to them and to us that that relationship continues in a very healthy way. And it is equally important to us in this very dangerous world that we live in that Pakistan and the UK are friends and continue to be friends. So thank you all, thank you very much for your time, and please come back again and see us. Thank you.
Thank you for very eloquently articulating your sentiments regarding the Pakistani community here in Walthamstow. I'd now like to invite a member of the Board of Governors of WCOP, the Principal of Adson and Khan Solicitors, Mr. Gul Nawaz Khan.
Coming together is a beginning. Keeping together is a progress. And working together is a success. Thank you very much to be part of this event, this program. We have a privilege, the presence of Waltham First Council, Mayor. Before I request our honourable last speaker for his concluding remarks about today's programme, I want you, all of you, so please show yourself that Pakistan hearing you. So please say with me, Pakistan, Zindabad! Pakistan, Zindabad! Pakistan, Zindabad! Please put your hands together to welcome the Mayor of Waltham Forest, Councillor Terry Wheeler. Thank you.
Yes, I think the Dean demonstrated, Councillor Dean Malley demonstrated why on Tuesday I asked him to act as Master of Ceremonies for my St Patrick's Day celebration. He does have that knack with a big audience of cheering everyone up, as he says. But can I just go back to why we're here? Because I think it's quite, you know, it is an important occasion. Nadine's quite right. It's about celebration. What are we celebrating? You're celebrating the realisation of aspiration, because back in 1914, Lahore, Mohammed Jinnah and others saw that the way forward was to have a separate Pakistan nation in the Indian subcontinent. And that was realised in 1947 in the sense of becoming independent from the United Kingdom. But in 1956 was perhaps also important day, because that was the day when Pakistan ceased to be a dominion, where they still had the Queen. Yes, the Queen. It's such a long time, you have to remember. The Queen as the head of state, and it became an Islamic Republic. So it's important to remember why we celebrate. Sometimes we lose sight of that, and it's always important that we remember principles and aspirations. You can't always achieve what you want to do. But you have to keep them in your mind and do what you can to achieve them. And Stella remarked about young people, and I think another thing that impressed me was also this magazine. You've got Malala on the front of it. And I just thought, well, Malala is actually another Mandela-type figure. So it's someone that Pakistan community should be really proud of. that she continues to campaign and articulate very, very well on the international stage a number of causes she's now associating herself with. And I look for that locally, and I was very pleased. Stella was there as well, with three of our young Muslim women from the Pakistan community, very shortly after the Peshawar disaster, and it was a disaster, organised a candlelit vigil in our town centre. And that was really gratifying, that you know our young people are prepared to come forward and do that from the Muslim community. And it does. I am proud of being. I was born in Waltham Forest, just across the road, actually. And I passed something called the 11 Plus, just next door. I'm quite proud of Waltham Forest. I'm proud of the place that Waltham Forest has in East London. I think East London began in the East. And Heathrow stole it to the west. And agree with that. but now I think the opportunity is, to pull London, the focus of London, over towards East London. And of course, when we're talking about pulling the focus of London, we are talking about, aren't we, the greatest city in the world? Yes, even more so than Lahore or Pune and Karachi, because we live here. It's our town. It's our city. So I'm very proud of Waltham Forest. I'm very proud of being an East Londoner and being a Londoner. And I'm very proud of the contribution that the Pakistan community is making in Waltham Forest. And I'm pleased to see that that mantle is being handed down. That some of the problems with some of us is we hold on to things for too long. But we can see there's a very active, vital, young Pakistan community that is really making a contribution to life in Waltham Forest and therefore in the whole of London. But can I thank you all for being very patient, because you've been sitting here now for nearly 2 hours, which is a long time by any extent. You're much, much better behaved, and Chris will testify this, than the councils often are, listening politely and patiently to everyone. So thank you very much for coming. And I should also thank our guest, Saeed Abbas, who is His Excellency the High Commissioner, for gracing us with his presence today. And I do hope I think everyone's invited you back so far. Chris is the latest throughout the day, and we hope to see you again later in the year and many more times whilst you're the High Commissioner. But anyway, I think it's not on the programme, so I'm going to do my presentation now. Yes. And I've added to it because one of the things about being proud is, of course, there's someone called William Morris. I won't go around and question which what I usually do, who is an important person both in world design and also in world politics, because he's one of the original founders of the socialist, social democratic movement. So, and he made a mark in Waltham Forest, the William Morris Gallery, and so one of the little things to take away is a tie, which the reason the tie has William Morris design on it, and it's nice and easy to carry, which I'm seeing being practical, you see, could have found something more bulky, but hopefully you'll enjoy wearing that at some point in time, and that reminds you of Waltham Forest and William Morris. And this is to damage your baggage allowance on the way back to Pakistan in the future, and it's likely to end up on the floor. If I may I'll give it to you.
Could be right.
And then we'll show everyone else what it is.
Yeah,
this is a shield, by the way.
We are now drawing to close of the ceremony. Thank you very much for your presence over here. But before we do, in traditional Pakistani style, the way we do it, we're going to offer 1 millionama here. May I request those children who were present here in the morning to come to my side, where I'll be inviting Dr. Ashfaq Khan on the stage to, in fact, sing 1 millionama, one patriotic song with all the kids around. May I request the children to stand up and come over here. At the same time, Dr. Ishfaq Khan, if he could come over and deliver this song. And while the song is playing, we'll be drawing close the ceremony as well.
Thank you very much for having me here. I'm an investor, Pakistani investor. मैं आप लोगों को ज़्यादा वक्त नहीं दूंगा मैं एक बहुत अच्छा मिलने का पेश करूंगा आपके सामने और मैं चाहूंगा कि पेशे हैं जो हम स्कूल में ज़ाहिर है पाकिस्तान में तो नहीं है लेकिन जब हम पाकिस्तान के बारे में सोचते हैं तो वो शेर मुझे याद आता है जिंदगी जब भी किसी शेर की तरफ बढ़ती है जिंदगी जब भी किसी शेर की तरफ बढ़ती है मेरे होंठों से तेरा नाम मचल जाता है ये पाकिस्तान को हम इस तरह मिस करते हैं तो मैं अब आपके सामने मेरी नमा पेश करूंगा फिर लो
वतन प्यारे वतन पाक वतन पाक वतन ऐ मेरे प्यारे वतन पाक वतन ऐ मेरे प्यारे ऐ वतन पाक वतन
Thank you.
brings us close to the ceremony. So let's give a big round of applause at the same time to all those who participated, all who organized it, all who hosted it. So let's give a big hand, big round of applause.
Assalamu alaikum. Aaj 23 March ke hawale se yahan London Borough of Waltham Forest ke andar ek takreeb ka ehtimam kiya gaya, jahan par mera pure London se aaye the log, Pakistani community ke. تقریب جو ہے وہ بہت ہی شاندار تھی. میرا خیال ہے کہ ایسی تقریب جو ہیں وہ یہاں پر کمیونٹی کو انگیج رکھنے میں اور ہمارے بچوں کو یہ یاد دلانے میں کہ ہم پاکستان سے بلانگ کرتے ہیں اور پاکستان سے محبت اجاگر کرنے میں بہت اہم کردار ادا کرتی ہیں. میرا خیال ہے کہ ایسی تقریبات کا انعقاد اور بڑے پیمانے پہ ہونا چاہیے اور مور ریگولر ہونا چاہیے. تھینک یو.
آئی ووڈ لائک ٹو کنگریچولیٹ ڈاکٹر سہیل چوہتائی اینڈ دی organizers of the World Congress of Overseas Pakistanis in organizing this fantastic event in Waltham Forest Town Hall on this Sunday, the 22nd of March 2015, to commemorate the Pakistan Day, the 23rd of March. There is great hope for our country, and there are problems. But the enthusiasm and the emotion that I've seen here and that we've all witnessed here demonstrates that we have the determination to overcome these problems and rise to the challenges and overcome these problems and march towards a wonderful future. Dr. Chowdhury is doing a great job in bringing the history and the background of Pakistan and presenting it to the coming generations.
My name is Afzal Akram. I'm the chairman of the Smile Group of Businesses, and I would like to take this opportunity to wish everybody a happy Pakistan Day. We had a function here today at the Walthamstow Town Hall where we celebrated Pakistan Day. We had over 150 guests here, including the mayor, the local member of parliament, and His Excellency the High Commissioner of Pakistan. It's good to see the Pakistan community coming out and celebrating their roots, and it's important for our young people to see that and see how important it is to us. So I wish all the Apex viewers a happy Pakistan Day, and hopefully see you again shortly.